Got an American Standard metering faucet. Ordered this thing in from Amazon. American Standard, part number 1340225.002, chrome metering center set faucet, cast brass, conventional spout with metal handles, 1 gallon per minute male aerator, vandal resistant, less grid drain. Now, one thing that it doesn't tell you here, when you open this thing up and install it, is that I don't know what it's set at, but it wouldn't shut off. I mashed this thing down and it just kept pouring. One thing also that I noticed is this little tab that you see right here. I think that's what they call a tamper resistant device to keep you from unscrewing that filter screen there on the end. A 25 millimeter wrench will allow you to take this top cap off, then you can rotate this plastic nut under here to adjust the flow of water that you're looking for. Like I said, it doesn't say in there that, oh, by the way, if you disconnect your drain while you're under there thinking, okay, I'll just kill two birds with one stone, guess what? It won't quit running. So I had to quickly reach up and turn the valve. Okay, I'm at this point here. I've got it all screwed down in there. You notice this little hole right here. It says push on it. This one gets the red tab for the hot side. And the other one gets a little blue tab for the cool side. As you can see right here, there's a little indentation on this spool up here. And what this does is when you take the set screw in this hole here, 2.5 millimeter, you unscrew that down in the bottom there. You can see it has a set screw I've already pulled all the way back. Put that down over there, tighten up the set screw, mash it down like it says flush, like an idiot here. I've done the same thing again. Now I've got water just to pour. So, lesson learned. Better have a bucket down underneath there, ready to catch. Well, as you can see, I didn't really intend for that thing to be running again, but this thing mashes down so easily. And if you've got the water turned on again, here I did the hot side first and the cold side, and I had both of these things running like a wild Indian. And like I said, I've got the drain disconnected. While I was in there, I figured I'd just clean all that out. And rather than hook it all up first, I thought I'd adjust this faucet. So I'm going to have to get the wrench and see exactly how slow we can make her go. All right, just a little instructions. If your wife has Alzheimer's, do not lay the only copy of the English instruction sheet laying around so that it disappears after searching for at least 2 hours. And being as I don't understand Spanish and French, I couldn't figure out exactly how to adjust this metering valve on this American Standard faucet. Also, when your wife washes dishes in this sink all the time and you've got a problem with all of the trash going down in there, believe me, that's going to get eat up. Okay, this is the way that the pipe came apart. This piece here was so tight, I ended up having to take a hacksaw because I could not disconnect this piece going down from the top, and it had a big nut on the bottom. I also had that stopper mechanism in there, so this nut that you'd think you could just unscrew and then pull this out the top did not work that way. I like to never got the hacksaw in there to get this thing sawed apart. So what happened was this piece here rotted away up inside the drain pipe. Needless to say, it was only a matter of time before this was going to come apart anyway. So like I've said lately, there's no such thing as an easy job. So after a quick trip over to Lowe's to pick up a few pieces to put this P-trap back in here, inch and a half pipe. I also got a new laboratory grid strainer, so I'm going to try to get this installed. It does have a grid on top, so maybe the trash won't go down in there as easily. And then after we get this thing hooked up, then we'll try the metering adjust. All right, I got this hole cleaned out here. Put some putty on this new pipe. Stick her down in there. Hopefully everything down under here is going to hook up all right. I've got the new pipe P-trap set up here. Hopefully this thing will slide in there. Maybe be able to pull it around and hook that up somehow. We'll check it out here in a moment. All right, had to use this little 6-inch extension here to connect up the trap. It's not completely tight yet, but at least it's hooked up and ready to go. All right, so that looked like, man, that must have been 30 seconds. That's quite a long time to be running. Not too bad. Check this other side here and see how it's doing. That was the hot. Kind of an aggravating sound, but at least I know when it's shut off. I think I'm just going to leave it like this for now, and if I have to adjust it later on, then I will. So it is really nice though to have the instructions in English about adjusting the cycle time. Again, like I said, this is the old man. Do not leave your camera laying around. Don't leave the instructions. Only God knows how many things disappeared here. Signing off. Hoping this thing will solve the problem. Have a good day. James 4:4. Yeah, I used all these tools. Wouldn't hurt to have a few more, plus the saw from Harbor Freight to saw that pipe off. So, it's working just fine though. American Standard, I think I'm not going to put those little blue and red markers in here until later on. Made this movie about how to install this metering faucet. A couple of little corrections there. I did not use a hacksaw. I used a sawzall with a blade to cut that pipe. And man, I'm telling you, when you're trying to hold that thing from the top and the bottom, was a challenge. I finally had to get my grandson to help me hold that thing. I also found out that it was not set to run continuously. It did, in fact, last about 30 seconds and did shut off. And those noises, and I remember looking at one of the videos on YouTube that said to pump that thing about 5 or 8 times, something like that, to disperse all the air out of the system, and that's what was making that little squeaking noise. I did not purge it. And so now that we've used it for a day, no more little squeaking sound when it shuts off. Really, really an amazing little handy thing that you don't have to worry about the water being turned on at 3 o'clock in the morning, not at all the rest of the night. Thank you very much. And again, like I said, John Boyd.